GTA San Andreas collectibles. We're on the Oyster locations, 40 through 50. Double A gamer for life. Okay, so now we're getting to the easy part, the last of the oysters. No wanted levels to be dealing with, and that's pretty nice. Got all the hard part done. It's been a long road, and I don't know how many wasted trips to the hospital it took to get to this point, but we're here now, and we're down to the last 10 oysters, and there's a pretty big payday at the end when you get all 50 of them, which is nice. Not that I'm hurting for money, but I don't turn it down, that's for sure. All right, so once you get a boat, head to the east side of the map here, swim with the dolphins a little bit. I went back to the dock that I always go to get the boat because besides that point, I can't think of any area that has a boat there that's there full time. So instead of wasting time running around the map looking for a boat, I just went to where I knew the boat was. And like I said, the whole point of doing this is I'm killing quite a few birds with one stone at this point. My lung capacity is maxed out. I'm getting a lot of driving skill to get back and forth to that dock. My stamina is almost full, if not already full. I'm getting some muscle mass. You know, and obviously the collecting the oysters in the process too. So it's all good. Like for me, before I go off and play the game, you know, I will do everything that I could possibly think of before I start the missions. Prior to doing the oysters, I already did the ambulance and the fire, so I got that done. So I'm already fireproof. My health is at max. You can see that the red bar is under the weapon, and when you start the game, it's like to the right side of the weapon picture there. When you complete the ambulance, which is 12 levels, it'll give you max health, and so that gives you your increased thing. As you can see, I just lost a little muscle there, so I must have forgot to go get something to eat. But at this point, I'm not going to really sweat losing a little bit of muscle if I'm getting to the end of my oysters. So when Grand Theft 4 came out, they kind of did away with that whole physique thing, muscle, all that. Nico could eat food, but that was just to replenish his health. They didn't have ambulance missions, anything like that. And to be honest with you, I can't really remember if there was anything Nico could do to max out his health. And I don't even believe like doing the vigilante missions gave you a boost in armor either. It was just an achievement or whatever it was. You know, once you got in a cop car, you activated the computer, and there's like two style of vigilantes you can do. But anyway, this is San Andreas, and this is the way it was set up, and pretty awesome game. It's just the very first time I played it, I remember like my M4, I had Hitman level just at the very end when I beat Tenpenny or whatever, and I was like, well, that's really useful to me now. So now when I play the game, I go off and I do all that in the beginning part of the game. So every weapon, the silenced pistol, the regular pistol, the Desert Eagle, the MAC-10, the Tech-9, the MP5, every weapon that has a Hitman level, I will do that in the very beginning part of the game and get that over with. So Anytime I'm doing something, I'm at Hitman level automatically, so. And that'll be under the weapons playlist or whatever. I'll show you how I did it. Pretty easy. Especially if you take the time to spray the tags, you will have to do the first mission at least, so you can get CJ's house open so you can get in there and get your weapons. But finding the M4 you can get right at the airport. I'll show you how to get a pilot license right in the beginning part of the game. It's super easy. You don't have to wait to get to the driving school, so once you get a pilot's license, you can just drive into the airport. You don't have to, figure a way to jump in the wall and all that kind of stuff. But the benefit for getting all the oysters is that it gives you max sex appeal. And you don't have to work to get the girls to be your girlfriend. Anytime you walk up to a girl that could be a girlfriend, they will automatically just ask you for your number. They'll say, "Hey, I'm Helena, can I have your number? Hey, I'm Katie, can I have your number?" And Barbara, and so forth and so on. So Denise is mission related. You meet her, through the mission. And then she becomes your girlfriend. With or without the sex appeal, she's like one of the easiest girls to please and all that kind of stuff. But all the other girls take a little bit of work if you don't have all the oysters. And just a kind of a pain. Barbara wanted you to be fat. You'd have to have your weight well over half, so you were pretty chunky. And then Elena wanted you to be under 20% muscle mass, so that kind of sucked. And I forget exactly what Katie's situation was to make her your girlfriend, but it's been so long because I do this at the beginning part of the game. I don't want to have to sweat it. I just walk up to them, and they automatically become my girlfriend. So. As you can see there, my stamina is almost at max, and my lung capacity is already there, so. Okay, there's actually an oyster in the same waterway a little bit north of it where I'm at. I don't know why I didn't go get it at that point, but I wanted to get the last one that I needed a boat for to get to so I can go get something to eat so I didn't lose any more muscle mass. Okay, so the next one I believe is at the end of the lighthouse pier. Right there's the lighthouse. We got some coral growing up out of the water. Obviously, any of these around Los Santos, you didn't really need a boat to do, but it was the fastest way to get to it. So from here, I'm just going to run up onto the beach. I believe I got a motorcycle stashed in my safe house. I went and got something to eat, so I had a little bit of fat on me, so I don't lose any more muscle mass. Well, I guess I didn't get something to eat. There's a spray tag for later. The oyster's just a little bit south of here, underneath that bridge. There it is, I can see it in the water. And when I was in the boat, I could have just easily came up here and got that, but whatever. Okay, so there's only two more left, and one's at Mad Dog's house, which we're at right now, and then the other's in Glen Park. So It's been a long journey. As you can see on the map, it says CJ, so like that's right at Grove Street at his house when Tenpenny drops you off in his car, and I haven't even gone there yet. I got $1 million. I've got the ambulance done. I'm fireproof. Bought a few homes. And I'm going to have all the oyster collected. So when we get into playing the game, dating the women will be easy peasy. I won't have to do shit to get them to be my girlfriend. As you can see, the money thing going up, that's a nice chunk of cash. But I've already did the ambulance and the fire. Then I went and did some off-track betting. And made a little bit of money there. I actually wind up with like 11, 12 million because I put $1 million down on a 10-to-1 horse and got some major money. But that's going to wrap up the oysters. So if you fancy doing the oysters in the beginning part of the game, this is a good way to do it. And, you know, like I said, don't worry about losing your weapons if you get wasted or anything like that. It's not important. You know, the only thing that's important is just getting all the oysters and then moving on. All right, so from here, we're going to go spray the tags. AA Gamer for Life. If you like the videos, you can always support us by checking out the ads.